This episode of Because Science is sponsored by the science of Mortal Kombat. This is why Link is stronger than most superheroes. The Legend of Zelda's Link is one of gaming's most iconic characters. He's the hero of time, banisher of evil, and smasher of pots. But despite all of his superheroic efforts through the decades, Link is never really portrayed with any of the superpowers you might expect him to have, like super strength. Thanks to video game logic, though, and what we can figure out with physics, I think that Link must be way stronger than we think, stronger than most superheroes. If we want to compare or calculate the strengths of fictional characters, we should start with the easiest possible determination of strength that we could apply to all of them. And I think that the simplest way to get at the base strength of a character like Link is to estimate the kinds of forces that that character can apply to an object, whether that force comes from a simple lift or an impact. Oh, 20. Sick. So all we have to do is find some scenarios that showcase Link's strength, use some basic equations, and make some really good assumptions, and then see what we get. Let's start with an example from the most recent Legend of Zelda game, Breath of the Wild. In the game, there's a very cool ability called Stasis, which allows you to freeze objects in space and time as you smash them. And it's only when the stasis runs out that all those built-up forces are imparted to the object. Gamers who try to complete Breath of the Wild as quickly as possible use stasis to great effect, launching themselves with built-up forces over ridiculous distances. And I think that one of these launches could give us an idea of just how strong Link might be. What just happened? If we simplify a Breath of the Wild Link launch greatly, then we have a classic case of projectile motion. To understand where we get the equations for projectile motion, we are now going to go through the complete mathematical derivation for all these equations in excruciating detail. What? Okay, fine, you're right. What we are actually more concerned with are all the values that we're going to have to estimate, from the height of Link to the angle of launch to the initial velocity of launch to the radius and therefore volume of the boulder, all of which we are going to now go through in excruciating detail. What? Okay, fine, I get it, dang. We just spoke. Breath of the Wild launches are a little tricky because there's no acceleration involved, which wouldn't happen in real life, and there are multiple strikes, and there's a bomb in play. But estimating some values that I don't want to bore you with, for a boy to launch a boulder that's twice as tall as he is through the air for multiple seconds and hundreds of feet, it would take a super heroic amount of force. If each of Link's stasis strikes are the same, then each one might impart almost 2 million newtons or 400,000 pounds of force. If it's the weight of our largest whales, then a single Breath of the Wild strike from Link would have as much force behind it as the weight of Jabu Jabu. And just think of how big a pot you could smash with this kind of force. These forces alone would launch Link into the realm of superheroes, but for Link's greatest feat of strength, we have to go back almost 20 years. Oh, there we go. Yep, good enough. In the classic Legend of Zelda game, Ocarina of Time, there are exactly two examples of Link's deceivingly immense strength that have stuck with me since I was a kid first playing it. It's when Link finally gets the golden gauntlets and does this. This kind of strength is ludicrous, and we can prove it. To me, the pillar thing that you throw inside and outside of Ganon's castle looks like a giant hexagonal prism. And it's hard to tell looking back at the game footage, and this isn't to scale, but the prism looks to be about 4 links tall, and the pyramid parts on top and bottom look to be about half a link tall, and the edges of the prism look to be maybe a single link wide. I said single, not tingle. No one wants a map. You make me uncomfortable, and everyone. If adult Link is around 1.7 meters tall, you can measure his height in the seaside laboratory if you're clever, then we can use that value to get the volume of the hexagonal prism that he throws. Do that and we get a volume for the pillar of 55 cubic meters. This would be the equivalent of thousands and thousands of pots. If each one of those pots held a few liters of volume, Sorry, I just gotta get them rooprips. If we then take the volume of the pillar and multiply it by the density of whatever the pillar is made out of, it looks to me like some kind of granite, we can get the amount of mass that Link can deadlift. Do that and you get almost 150,000 kilograms. Again, interestingly, almost the mass of an entire Jabu Jabu if that fish boy is blue whale sized. When Link picks up those pillars in Ocarina of Time, he is breaking the world deadlift record for a human by a factor of 250. And this isn't even Link at full power! Link has to be stronger than some of the most famous superheroes because he lifts and throws giant pieces of stone like they are as light as Deku nuts. Thanks to scientists like Isaac Newton, we know that it takes more force to accelerate an object more quickly. For example, it takes less force for me to just raise this pot up off the ground, basically just fighting its weight, than it does for me to launch it into the air. For a more human example, the world deadlifting record is over 1,000 pounds, but the world record for the heaviest keg that you can throw up over behind your head, just like Link throws that pillar, is under 60 pounds. A lot less. So if Link is throwing hundreds of thousands of pounds up over his head like it's nothing, then he is making the mountain here look like a molehill. Looking again at the Ocarina of Time toss, we can use the same kinds of projectile motion equations that we did for the Breath of the Wild boulder. All we have to do is get the same kinds of values that we're looking for, like angle of flight and time of flight. Basically, we want to know how much force it will take to give the initial velocity required to carry the object on its projectile-like path. If our estimations and calculations are on the right track, in this scene in Ocarina of Time, Link is applying maybe 18 million newtons of force, or 4 million pounds of force, to the pillar in question. This is rocket launch levels of strong. If this is the case, then Link has more lifting power than the SpaceX Falcon Heavy rocket. If Jabu Jabu is the weight of a blue whale, he could pick him up and toss him the same distance as the pillar in question. He could just, at the end of the game, grab Ganon by the tail and toss him out of Hyrule Castle for good. Woo! Give me a pot to break. Come on! Whew. As many superheroes are defined by their strength, it's not that hard to find hard values for their lifting capabilities, just like we calculated for Link, sprinkled throughout their various calamity cannons. For whatever reason, many superhero strength values are stated in tons. We calculated that Link could lift and throw 150 tons, each ton being 1,000 kilograms. And if that's the case, all other things being equal, just looking at strength, Link is canonically stronger than Batman, stronger than Captain America, stronger than Bane, stronger than Ultron, and stronger than Spider-Man. In fact, according to the sources that I could find, this value would make Link stronger than most superheroes. Isn't video game logic fun? Start! So, a single feat over A single feat over 20 years ago puts Link in the realm of superhero class strength. Sure, this strength isn't all his own. He needs the golden gauntlets, but that's fine. Iron Man needs a suit and Superman needs the sun. He may be just a kid, but don't count Link out because in the right situation, he would absolutely Hyrule. Because science. Come on, take me back to a simpler time. This is the darkest timeline. When Link lifts that pillar, that is impressive, definitely. But I did one other calculation that I didn't want to include for whatever reason, that if you had that kind of force, 150 tons, and you know, you apply that as a force, behind the Master Sword, on the edge of the Master Sword, the amount of pressure that would be there would be more than the pressure at the center of the Earth, which means that Link, if he stabbed anything, it would go through basically anything, which would make your fight with Ganon a lot shorter. Oh, you hit it out of my hand and I can only use the Megaton Hammer. Oh no, I'm gonna stab through your face.
I'm Kyle Hill. Join me as we test fatalities, brutalities, and realities in the science of Mortal Kombat.
Thank you you so much for watching, Magali. If you want more of me, please follow me and Because Science here at these social media handles where you can suggest ideas for future episodes. Sometimes I use them and they are very helpful to me. The big announcement that I have, though, is have you checked out the first episode of The Science of Mortal Kombat? Oh, we did an entire 6-episode series all about fatalities and moves that you can find in the history of Mortal Kombat, and it's a lot of premium science. You're gonna wanna check it out right here on this channel. Go back, watch it.